Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to receive payments in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. As a business owner, it's very important for you to keep track of the money that is owed to you, otherwise known as your accounts receivable balance. One of the ways you can do this is to create and send customer invoices using Xero. This gives you access to financial statements that are always up to date. The accounts receivable aging report is one of the key reports that will help you to track and manage your outstanding invoices. In this lesson, we discuss how to receive customer payments. In the next lesson, we'll show you how to create the AR aging report and use it to get paid faster. You can click here to access this lesson. In this lesson, we will discuss three types of customer payments: payment in full, partial payments, and prepayments or deposits. When a customer payment is equal to the outstanding invoices that you have on the books, that is considered payment in full. If a customer sends a payment in for an amount less than their outstanding invoices, that is considered a partial payment. Xero also allows your customers to make payments online. In the How to Set Up Invoices lesson, we showed you how to link a payment service to your Xero account. You can click here to access this lesson. Now let's go ahead and record a full or partial customer payment in Xero. To do this, you want to go ahead and navigate to Accounts and Sales, and go ahead and click on the Awaiting Payments tab here. And so these are all of our outstanding invoices awaiting payment. And so to select an invoice, you want to simply just click within that row, and then the invoice will display. If we scroll down to the very bottom of the invoice, this is where we can see the section on where we can record a payment. The amount paid field will auto-populate with the total amount due for the invoice. If the customer payment matches this amount, meaning it's a payment in full, then you can leave it as is. However, if the customer's payment is less than the amount in this field, which means it would be a partial payment, then you want to go ahead and enter the amount of the customer payment that you received here. Please note that while this has never happened to me, you may encounter a situation where a customer sends you a payment that exceeds the outstanding amount due, which would be considered an overpayment. Go ahead and enter the amount received from the customer, and then you can learn more about how to handle overpayments by clicking the link below this lesson. In the Date Paid field, you want to enter the date that you deposited the payment into your bank account. If you have not made the deposit yet, then enter the date that you plan to make the deposit with the bank. Please note, in order to avoid any issues with reconciling later on, you need to ensure this date is as accurate as possible. Paid to. From the dropdown, you want to go ahead and select the bank account that you deposited the payment to. If you have not set up your bank account yet, you must do so before you can record customer payments. Click here to access this lesson on how to set up bank accounts. The reference field is an optional field. If the customer paid by check, then you can use it to enter the check number as we have done in this example, or you can use it to enter any information that you would like to include as part of the customer's payment. Once you've completed all of the fields, you can click this Add Payment button to record the payment. Once you've added the payment, you should see a notification similar to this one that says that the payment has been received. You can send your customer a receipt for the payment by clicking on the Send Receipt link here. When you select this option, a template will open up for you to complete in order to send this information to your customer. So let's talk about this now. In the email template, Xero will automatically populate the Send Receipt To field with the email address that you saved in the customer contact details. If you have not set up an email address, or if you would like to add additional recipients, you can do so directly in this field. be sure to separate each email address with a semicolon in between. Branding theme. This field will automatically populate with the branding theme or template that you set up in the How to Set Up Invoices lesson. You can click here to access this lesson. To select a different branding theme, just select it from the drop-down here. Email template. This field will automatically populate based on your email settings. Click the link below to learn more about how to set up your email settings for your documents that are sent to or from customer and supplier contacts. Subject. Xero will automatically populate the standard subject. You can make any changes that you would like to personalize the subject directly in this field. And the message here is also a standard message that Xero will automatically include. You can easily make changes to send a more personalized message to your customers by typing directly in this box. If you select this box next to Send Me a Copy, then you will receive a copy of the exact email that your customer will receive. Once you're satisfied with the message and you're ready to send it to your customer, simply click the Send button and your email along with the PDF attachment of the customer's receipt will be sent. In How to Manually Enter Bank and Credit Card Transactions, we showed you how to record prepayments received from customers for products or services that you will provide sometime in the future. You can click here to access this lesson. Let's walk through the steps to apply prepayments to customer invoices. So return back to the sales area, and then you will see a list of the categories for your invoices. You want to click on the Awaiting Payments tab once again. And then the prepayments will be tagged with the yellow double P, as you can see here, and we've got a prepayment that was made here. So to select the prepayment that you'd like to work with, you go ahead and just click simply in this row here and it will display the prepayment. And then over to the right, go ahead and click on prepayment options and select allocate credit. In this screen, you will see a list of all the open invoices for this particular customer. In the amount to credit field, you want to enter the amount of the prepayment that you would like to apply to the appropriate invoice. So we've got a prepayment of $500, so we're going to go ahead and apply that to this actual invoice number 10010 for $500. So let's go ahead and enter that amount here. Notice there's a cash refund option here. If you'd like to refund the deposit back to the customer, you want to go ahead and select this option. Otherwise, we've got our outstanding credit balance of $500. Total amount that we're applying is $500. So remaining credit balance will be zero after it's been applied to this invoice. Once you're satisfied with your selections, we can go ahead and click Allocate Credit. You should see a notification similar to this one that says that our credit has been allocated. And notice that we're back on the prepayment that we first selected. And here at the bottom, we've got a less credit to. So now this credit is showing the invoice that we applied it to. And as we discussed, the remaining credit balance will be zero. So please note that if you do not want to allocate a credit to the open invoices that are currently in Xero, you can create an invoice and then return to this screen to allocate the prepayment accordingly. That wraps up the lesson on how to receive customer payments in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.